Hey everyone, welcome back to The Digital Solution. Today we're talking about a question many people ask. How to download HappyMod on your iPhone, iPad, or any iOS device. The truth is you both can and cannot do it. And I'll explain exactly what that means in simple terms. First, open your browser, Chrome, Safari, or anything, and go to happymod.com. You'll see a download button right there. When you click download, it shows APK. Now what does APK mean? APK is the file format used by Android apps. It's short for Android Package. These files are made to work only on Android devices because they run on a Java-based system. iPhones, on the other hand, do not use APK files. They use IPA files or App Store applications that are verified and managed by Apple. That means you cannot directly install an APK file on iOS. So in short, HappyMod is designed for Android, not for iPhones or iPads. Now, technically, there is one way to make it work, but it's risky. That way is called jailbreaking your iPhone. Jailbreaking removes Apple's software restrictions and allows you to install apps that are not approved by the App Store. However, this is not recommended at all. It can break your device, remove important security protections, void your warranty, and even expose your data to serious risks. Also, depending on where you live, jailbreaking can be illegal or violate Apple's terms of service. That's why I will not show you how to do it. My video is only for educational purposes, and I'm not responsible if anyone damages their phone while attempting to jailbreak. So yes, you technically can install HappyMod after jailbreaking, but it's not a smart or safe option. If you go online, you'll find tons of videos or websites claiming that you can easily download HappyMod on iOS without jailbreak. Most of those are fake or clickbait. They usually waste your time or ask you to complete fake verifications. Some even try to install harmful software on your phone. Please avoid those scams. My honest advice is simple. Don't install HappyMod on iOS. It's not worth the risk. If you want access to apps that aren't available in your region, there are safe alternatives, like changing your App Store region, using Test Flight for beta apps, or simply contacting the developer to ask for an iOS version. I hope this video helps clear up the confusion. If you found it useful, give it a like, and if you didn't, you can dislike. Either way, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Stay safe. And use your iPhone wisely.